Dr. Freeman! A mess out there. This close to the Citadel, they've turned the streets over to Striders. I think we can push them back if we can just get to high ground. We're almost to the Citadel wall, Doc. I don't know how the hell we're gonna breach it, but you've made it this far. I'm sure you'll think of something. We have to get to the horse! Dr. Freeman. I'll come with you.
Yourself up.
Thank you. crashing through the plaza, knocking over walls, and I think he's looking for Alex. He seems to have it set in his head that she's in the Citadel. I figured Alex wouldn't want him getting any deeper in trouble, but hell, you try stopping him. Hey, dog! Not there! You can't get through that way! I think he wants you to go through, Gordon. You'd better hurry. And if you see Dr. Breen, tell him I said...
Thank you. Security alert. Unregistered weapons detected. Confiscation field engaged.
So, this is Dr. Freeman, at last. I wish I could say this was a pleasant surprise, but it's neither a surprise nor, as you refer to me, a pleasant. Well, I am nothing if not pragmatic. Circumstances, I like to think we might have been able to work together in an atmosphere of mutual trust and respect. Certainly judging from your brief tenure at Black Mesa while I was at Minister.
Mentors are partly to blame, of course. My disappointment in Eli Vance and Isaac Kleiner is far greater than my sorrow over your unfortunate choice of career path. In a way, I suppose you could not have done otherwise. Who knows what seeds of iconoclasm they planted when you were young and gullible, but while they certainly share a great part of the responsibility for the recent troubles, it is you alone who have chosen to act with such willful disregard for humanity's future.
Thank you.
I have laid the foundation for humanity's survival. And not as we have narrowly defined ourselves, but as something greater than we could ever imagine. Something we can now only begin to glimpse.
Thank you.
foundation for humanity's survival.
I'll take him from here. Don't struggle. It's no use. Until you're where he wants you, there's nothing you can do. I'm sorry, Gordon.
Carbon stars with ancient satellites colonized by sentient Fuji. Gas giants inhabited by vast meteorological intelligences. Worlds stretched thin across the membranes where the dimensions intersect. impossible to describe with our limited vocabulary.
What I've seen is also beyond words, Breen. Genocide. Indescribable evil. Good God.
Well, if it isn't Gordon Freeman at last. What's this? I'll put it over there. You have my gratitude, Doctor. First you lead me straight to the doorstep of my oldest friend, and then you deliver yourself? If I'd known you were going to come straight up to my office, I wouldn't have bothered hunting you in the first place. Having both of you in my keeping ensures I can dictate the terms of any bargain I care to make with a Combine.
Dr. Breen.
Huh?
Wallace.
Yes, Judith, what is it?
The bargain we should be making is for Eli's life so he can continue his research.
Thanks to you, we have everything we need in that regard. You're more than qualified to finish his research yourself. What neither you nor I can do is convince that rabble in the streets to give up their senseless struggle. Yet Eli refuses to speak the words that would save them all.
Save them? For what?
Eli, if you won't do the right thing for the good of all people, maybe you'll do it for one of them.
Alex, honey.
Dad. Gordon? No.
God damn you, Breen, you let her go.
That's all up to you, my old friend. Will you let your stubborn short-sightedness doom the entire species, or will you give your child the chance her mother never had?
How dare you even mention her?
Alex, my dear, you have your mother's eyes, but your father's stubborn nature.
You haven't seen a bit of it yet.
Really? Well, let's see how well it serves you on the far side of a Combine portal.
Go ahead, Breen. If that's the worst you can do, send us both through your portal.
Oh, it's hardly the worst. But you might find that hard to believe once you get there.
It isn't necessary.
I agree. It's a total waste. Fortunately, the Resistance has shown it is willing to accept a new leader. And this one has proven to be a fine pawn for those who control him.
No!
Don't listen to him, Gordon.
How about it, Dr. Freeman? Did you realize your contract was open to the highest bidder?
Gordon would never make any kind of deal with you.
I understand if you don't wish to discuss this in front of your friends. I'll send them on their way, and then we can talk openly.
Don't struggle, honey.
Dad, I'm so sorry.
Alex, sweetheart.
Judith? What do you think you're doing?
We're doing what I could never do alone. We're stopping you.
Yes.
Guards, get in here!
They know you betrayed them. They'll turn on you.
Judith, Dr. Mossman, please!
I'm sorry, Wallace. You're all out of time. Don't...
Hurry! Dad, hang on!
You fool!
Watch out, he's gonna-
No!
Dad!
Oh, no, no, no. Don't worry about me, honey.
There's no time, Alex. He's on his way to the portal. You'll need this.
Dr. Mossman, Judith, look after my father.
Don't you worry.
Dad, I'm not saying goodbye.
Never.
Come on, Gordon. Let's go.
It's my girl.
Gordon, we haven't known each other very long, but I know you didn't have to do this. I had to rescue my father, but you... Well, thanks for coming after me.
It's me you should be concerned.
Hey, listen.
I can still deliver.
That's him.
But not without your help. The portal destination is untenable. Surely you can set the relay elsewhere.